I greet everyone to this morning in the name of Jesus Christ the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah, church.
Amen.
Well, you are most welcome. And let us enjoy the word of God together. The grace of God is so sufficient that we may hear from the Lord, that we may apply what God tells us to apply. God, out of his own love, the love with which he loves us, he made a provision for each one of us, that each one of us must not have any lack, must not fail in life. And this provision that God has made is taken, is fetched, and is taken by our faith. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why our topic today is continuing with what we have started last time. Application of the law of faith. Application of the law of faith. I said faith is the law. And when we cooperate with this law, there's no way that we cannot be successful, because it is observable and it is tangible. It can be followed. It's simple enough. It's for everyone. Hallelujah, church. Now, this law of faith denies for you to remain in bondage. Then it totally denies for you to remain in bondage of any circumstance. It can be a bondage of fear. It can be a bondage of leg. It can be a bondage of anything. Maybe a bondage of financial instability. Bondage of whatever you may think of. This application of the law of faith denies you to remain in that bondage. The application of the law of faith denies for you again to remain deceived of your inheritance. God has prepared an inheritance for you. And that inheritance belongs to you. He loves you. That is why the faith we have, it's not what we created. No, we didn't create it. God the Father himself, out of his own love, realized that we will be weakened and we will not be able to succeed. He decided to bring the weapon with which we must be able to fetch the blessings from him. And that weapon, it's called faith. This faith, or this application of the law of faith, denies for you to remain spiritually blind. It doesn't allow you to remain spiritually blind. Munduri, because if we are blind spiritually, we won't be able to see what God has prepared. Now, the measure of faith God dealt upon me doesn't allow me to remain blind spiritually. That when I go into the Word of God, the Spirit of God himself gets revealed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, the law of faith denies for us that we may always remain in the bondage of sickness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It denies for us that we may not that we will be deceived of the devil. Let's go to the book of Romans chapter
1.
We will couple it with Acts chapter 20 verse 32. But let's start from verse chapter 1 of Romans. We read verse 17. I want us to go with this way. It is, for in the gospel, a righteousness which God ascribes is revealed. Exactly. In the gospel, in the good tidings, the righteousness which God ascribes, it's revealed. It is not the righteousness that we made out of our own. It is the righteousness of God that God made. It's revealed. Both springing from faith to leading to faith. For it is written, the man who through faith is just. Shall live. And shall live by faith. You are the righteousness of God in Christ. Unless you apply the law of faith, you will never live. The Bible says, the righteous shall live by faith. Meaning that there's a law that needs to be applied.
unewa fanela kutebeli wa uri nurina basi bana mkofu bana mati bana mulino basi taba na mwrayo uneba utebele mshifuwa mamesezi hini nga uri jina mwrayo unezwa fanela kutebeli wa there's a law that needs to be observed that needs to be followed
unamele na fanela utebeli wa
you may have the millimeter. You may have the fire. You may have the pot. You may have even the electric stove. To cook. Unless you apply the law of cooking, you will never eat the food you want. Now, if we have the faith of God, and we have the word of God, we have the mouth, we have the heart, and we don't apply them according to the law, we will never enjoy what God speaks about. Somebody say amen. Now, today I want us to look at why it is so important to apply the law of faith. Number one, the enemy, the devil,
Satan,
attacks our faith because faith is our stronghold. It's the world where we fetch whatever we desire. Every day, when the devil attacks you, he wants to steal the faith in you so that you may not be able to stand. So I want us to look at it. In the book of Ephesians chapter 6, verse 16. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 16. I want us to look at it and go with it. It reads this way in verse 16. Lift up above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. Look at what the Bible says. God is saying, over all things, whether you are facing a problem, whether you having a need, above all things, take the shield of faith, and take the shield of faith with which you will quench the fiery darts of the
enemy.
Your faith is an instrument that makes you to reach your inheritance. This faith that I'm talking about, you didn't create it.
No,
not at all. You only received it by the grace of God. He decided to give you the faith. Yours is to apply. What you apply, there's no circumstance that you cannot overcome. No matter what, you cannot fail to be successful. You know, the other thing that makes people to fail, people think low about themselves. That is why the mind is telling him he is a very low person. Your faith is a stronghold, where everything starts from. I want us to look at something very important. You sustain your family through your faith. You cannot sustain your family unless you have faith. You cannot preserve your family unless you have your faith. Hello, church. Muta unego ne badzura khawo na zothe zwire hafala nga ngomu zwinga sikone u vha ḓifhela zwa vhatakadza vhone vho vhuya lutendo tshikwamani.
You have to take out that faith.
Because
when the attack comes in your family,
the
Bible says your faith quenches every attack that comes from
them.
It quenches everything. Now, if you have the faith
and
you decide to you make it to be dormant. Otherwise, you are not going to be successful in that family. Let me tell you something that is very important. And I want you to notice. God will never allow you to face something that he knows you won't make it.
Whenever you are not teaching about God, whenever I'm going to be making it.
Today, let me just tell you something very, very, very interesting. You can be successful through it. Whatever you have, whatever you're faced with, whatever challenge that's coming against you, God knows fully well that he has equipped you to overcome.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And there's no way that you cannot overcome. Because it's from faith to faith. And the faith we have is not our own making.
It's the
deliverance from the Lord. We received it from God the Father. You see, in the book of Psalm 127, when you read from verse 1 to 3, it talks something very important. Can we just look at it quickly? We pass by. 127, yeah. You look at this. 127, verse 1 to 3. It says, except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain who builds it. Except the Lord keeps the city, the watchman makes but in vain. It is in vain for you to rise up early, to take rest late, to eat the bread of anxiety, of toil, for he gives blessings to the beloved, it's
sick.
You're not going to be successful. That's what I'm saying. You cannot sustain your family without your faith. You cannot sustain or raise up your children properly without the element of faith. The application of your faith covers every area of your life. You cannot undo what the devil has done until you apply your faith, the faith God has dealt upon you, properly. You cannot maintain peace or see light in your life without the faith of God in you. Somebody say amen. You cannot maintain that peace. You cannot enjoy. Unaba tuba netu mwachikuna mazura mare. At buchirabu kubia ndifera. Eni nga mwogu sakudhibu. Nga uri nishifara hapa.
Ziawa.
Nishifara hapa. Azifarimidi. Nishifara hapa. Aziteli. What is the problem?
Not how it's going to
be. No, no, I'm going to put an example. Nga mwogu mwemtari ndari. Mudzimu hati ngeri wone vachiva na chitu chine vasadzava na nungo kacho. Ava wone na nisina kireni. Nita ngewe. Ava wone nisina chauri. Hezi zote zwe zatenda udapanda hanga. God has given me enough power to deal with them through the application of my faith.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Whatever is before me,
whatever
that is before me,
God
has dealt the measure of faith for it.
That
when I apply my faith, everything must come to. To the right position. When you go to the book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 16, where we read,
it
says, above all things, take ye the shield of faith,
with
which you will quench all the fiery
darts
of the
evil
one. Faith is a shield.
Faith
is a shield. You know, by faith, you can maintain the peace. By your faith, by the application of the faith, you can maintain peace in the family, you can maintain peace in your work, you can maintain peace in your own life. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
This morning I picked up some things that steal the joy in life. I want us to be awake so that we fight with it by faith. When you go to the book of Romans chapter 5 verse
1,
you will see what God says about you. But there are things that steal the joy. Number one, complicating simple issues. Just complicating simple things. Ujia vitu zisinana mshumo. Boni vajita tawa. Zava tawa kuru isana mereyi. Somebody say amen. Let's look at 2 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 3 only. And I want to try to emphasize a little bit on that one. Complicating simple issues. Second Corinthians chapter 11. Verse 3.
Ndira opa ori vunga nawa yokura ifa nga zvito zvayo. Mimbure yano anga ai inga yochinyi waya boyela Kristo chimbera.
Eh, ndikumbera uri bavara zvona bakuza vana mara ndikumbera uri zvidoto wana yo nga hukuku kubechera komeso zvona. Zvinga zvine zvila mara kesho. But now I'm afraid. Lest that even as the serpent beguiled Eve by the cunning, so your mind may be corrupted and seduced from wholehearted and sincere and pure devotion to Christ. Look, God is talking about the mind here. He says, in the Garden of Eden, Eve was deceived by the serpent. When the serpent came into the garden, it spoke something against the knowledge of God. The knowledge of God was that those people look into the garden and tender it and live in harmony over there.
They
live by the faith God has given them. But look at the serpent coming in, complicating simple things, complicating simple matters, and try to show that God did not mean that. Come on, Uto complicated zvito hezvilani zvaitisa uri wichiro buku on the water wichiro on that. Don't complicate matters. Don't complicate things. The devil will attack you day by day. The reason why God has given you the measure of faith
Is that every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, you must be able to combat it in the knowledge of your faith. Somebody say amen. There will be a day wherein the devil will come and speak something different so that you get confused. So don't complicate matters even if you're coming across difficulties. Look at it in the eye of faith. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
We have children at home. We have the other people, the in-laws and all those people at home. Now, when the devil comes, he wants to steal that joy. The devil comes but to steal, to destroy, and to kill. I want you to stand and stand like a door that nothing can penetrate through complicating simple issues. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Allow the spirit of faith to prevail in your life. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Avoid ungodly anger. This ungodly anger. These are the things that steal your joy. Don't you have something that you can combat that anger? Don't you have the measure of faith is within you that can combat the anger? Hallelujah, church.
Amen.
The Bible says you can be angry. Don't allow the sun to go down on your anger. Bone ba fedze mwezi sa zvino kono fedza miviri. Mora akubangana namashini.
Amen.
Vono fedza miviri zvino. Ende kuita namwana. Musaina. I want to say,
the devil
has sifted you.
Satan
and
found
you. Baba fefera wawana. Lord Church,
amen.
The reason why God has given us the measure of faith is that when we face the difficulties, let us apply what we have. Let us apply what we have. And what we have is the measure of faith. Every time when there is an attack, there must be a song that is heard from within. And we Hallelujah. If you look at Noah, he was told to build the ark. And as he was building the ark, he
just
went by. And people asked him, I suppose. And said, did you hear God? Is your God still with you? When is the rain coming? You know what the man did? He kept on doing what he believed in. He kept on continuing with what he.
Amen.
Amen.
Why? Because he had faith in God. He was fully persuaded, like Abraham, that whatever God has promised, God has the ability to bring it to fruition. Hallelujah. Even in your life, what God has promised,
don't
bring it to pass. If you don't know what God promised, one of them is, I will supply your needs according to my riches in glory by Christ Jesus. I will prepare a table in the presence of your enemies. Mudzimu uri udova kwa zvinwa pazvina vona veresa. Asheme zvine atinga atekiwa, ndi atekiwa. Mara praise God, I'm a winner.
Amen.
Because he supplies my needs. And again, he prepares a table for me in the presence of my enemies. They don't have to die. They have to realize that I belong to God. So don't complicate matters. Don't have ungodly anger. Apply your faith. Real good. Hello, church.
Amen.
How do you apply it?
We've
got the very same spirit of faith that when we believe, we speak. Yeah, we've got the same spirit of faith. And when we believe,
we speak.
Another thing that steals the joy is excessive reasoning. I gave an example this morning and I said, you see, when a person is having excessive reasoning, why is this mic silver? And they are having a red cord. Why is this one having a black head and a green cord? Why is this not the same as this one?
What do you mean? What do you
mean?
Amen.
Red and green in a meaning matters not. Am I talking to somebody here?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Stop from habitual discontentment. Hey! Discontentment. There is not any other person behind it. That's the devil.
Yeah.
He wants you to remain without joy. And when you have discontentment, when you have excessive reasoning, when you complicate simple issues, the problem is you don't sleep. And when you don't sleep, you're depriving yourself. You don't succeed. Nuri diabolo badiba una mukwa. Unga department of education in Fare. Unga department of education. Nuri arari home wanasa divi zavuti. Nama a fere kai class. Isha a fere kai class. Barhai. Mana fere class will be. Karimu yisere kaya panda. Baku mwisere kaya panda kumuinga mwemushumo nta hola ne abungubu wakumubare. Anani asaike zomu tibare hai. Mwana seri rubi kapu kere kaya panda. Abu ya shika kafu mtu asa kuno mwarori bibi ya baba yobare. What about form two? And how can you jump out of form two? What am I A? Are B? Are one? Are two? Are three? What about form two? How can you marry to be a baby? When I don't know what department of education is. That's what I want. But when I over open and open and over, I have a Zunga theater. Babu to there are students of the week. Zina ya goro, hezi alari achi titiza ziduguri. Haa, basunga wapena mbiru. Kari tuita 1, 2, 3. Aba inganga zimwe zineza itiza ori zusanja. Tenda uchibira. And you complicate matters. God has given us the faith to quench all the fiery deaths of the evil one. We must deny failure in our lives. We must deny failure in our lives. We must deny hatred in our lives. Somebody say amen. Habitual discontentment, you must stop it. Somebody say amen. Maraba kungera rishuke zvitobakagara na zvino zvitobakagara. Maraba funziko kuti vakaima vari apply the weapon God has given to you. And that is the weapon of the application of your faith. This is not what you created. It's God himself who has that upon you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Can we say, I'm a conqueror in Christ Jesus.
Nebuchiron yanga.
Zinanila yeso. Ndiyakunda ungani imwe na imwe ndibvapanda ngauri Yehovha una nne ndimulisa wanga atishai chithu china mbiti dzine dzaitisa kuti ndichinye nga dzina la Yesu. Ndina rutendo rune rwavaforora ndira imwe na imwe. Hallelujah. Sometimes when I don't have much, the devil tells me, should you give? So that you suffer again. You were suffering. Now you want to take even what you have. My faith says, God says, if I give, it shall be given back unto me. Good measures, pressed down, shaken together, overflowing. My faith says yes to it. Your faith must say yes to what God says. Because that is the weapon God has given you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Your faith again is the source of your protection.
It's
the source of your protection.
1 Thessalonians
chapter 5. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. Let's read verse 8. Am I talking to somebody yet?
Amen.
Is the Spirit of God speaking to somebody yet?
Amen.
Praise God forevermore. 1 Thessalonians. Praise God. Listen to what the Bible says there. It says, we who of light. We who are of light, let us be sober, let us be watchful, let us be vigilant, and we put on that faith. We will be attacked, and we will definitely be attacked. Ziri rebeda okazi wanga zani zuzina zari rebeda mbaz. Muna du ngori no bamba rutel. And tiga bida complicate mafu. Dito to imandari Yehova. Bone wamba uri. Unga diwa ngandaranti marauti barangani wanga zile tanambi. Muna du ngauri. The Spirit of God resides in me. And the faith of God is upon me. In this one says, but we belong to the day. Therefore let us be sober.
And put on the breastplate.
And
the spirit of love. And the helmet of hope of salvation.
Just like,
for God has not appointed to us or did not select us for condemnation.
Ori vachera ori rwana uchitwa nga murana wacho Isa Kristo.
Mudzimu auna mbiti yayo vachera munthu. Mbiti ine mudzimu ava nayo vachera diabo. Hello church.
Amen.
Apa tipo pera mbiro kwa vachona kuti amudzimu kuti mbiti yayo. Amudzimu kuti mupanisha. The judgment ya munthu. Mudzimu hongo ya mbiti oitara munthu. Mbiti ye mudzimu aive ya hongo itara munthu.
Amen.
Oitara diabo.
Amen.
Kuto bani muntu uyu timadhironge. Vamwe ndi vamadhironge wani. Pavai. Zvinhu zvavati. Madhironge ndi muntu wekudhironga. Do you understand madhironge? Okay. Madhironge. Let me play it with English that is ordinary. Madhironge is somebody who doesn't mind about somebody's matter, just get in.
Okay.
Putting himself, getting himself in unnecessarily. She not in so for it. She knows that diabolo. Bye. Did a madurum get in the diabolo? Meeting her like itchy back or there at diabolo, if you don't pack again, I'm a hero. Hello, Chad. Baba pray. Who chases the chitam? Arana chases the chitaka wana chodimba mochere. Who chases na ajo? Zino morena ache kore kugolwa dila na diaboro. Ora mo ne mama guma ne. Uri kono mati mero kwa zituuni. He has given us the measure of faith.
Arna mero
kwa. His faith.
Arna mero.
Denies us to suffer.
This
faith denies us to be embroiled into things that do not work.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is why the law of faith
will
never fail. The law of faith, when applied, it will never fail. No matter what, you will be attacked. You will be attacked.
You
will be attacked. You real good. But the diabol is the power of and those Mr. Weapons just stand firm.
Yeah. It's over.
Make use of the weapon God has given to you.
I'm going to talk to somebody here.
Amen. Maybe towards the end. The law of faith. The law of action. The law of faith. It's a law of action. I mean, if you don't act on what you believe, you're not applying the law. The law of faith is the law of action. Yeah, the law of action.
James 2:14,
James, chapter 2.
Verse 14. Yana ibarengora. Zvitarisana varatu vanga. Ava muto achiri una rupendo, asina mushumo. Kana rupendo rwako nomuchidza.
Read
arali muthu kana kana pepezi
kana tuke ndiye aunazokutea huni ikwamba uri arali muratu kana kana pepezi asina zofuka bone vasikomuravera saba chimbira zvavo mara vanazvo that's wrong now mara kare 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 ka iti
zvino mumwe angari iwe una rupendo nende na mushumo mutumbata upendo rwaro kuti na mishumo nende to tumbata upendo rwanga rukona rao nga mishumo iwe watenda zvauri mudzimu ndi mutihi woita zvone na mimuya mivii yatendako ichitetemera.
What I want to bring into this.
Nana kata mwanzo bisa na kagara ndo.
Faith
is an action verb.
You can say you believe in something.
Bona vari mutende kha chito.
And you don't action it.
Basa chite.
That's no faith.
Auna lutendo.
When you believe in forgiveness.
Musi vona vachitenda kwa hangwera.
Forgiveness is an action.
Bona ba vona nango hangwera.
You do it.
Mato zeita.
When we speak of love.
Richambanga
love is an action.
Rufuna ndinyita.
When we speak of giving.
Richambanga
unaya. Giving is an action.
Unaya ndinyita.
When we speak of stopping worry.
Muchambanga dzima.
Worry is an action.
Dzimambera ndinyita.
When the Bible says apply your faith.
Muchambira tirika vachu muchatendorapo.
It's an action.
Ndinyita.
You put it into action.
Bona vachishumisa.
Then it works for you.
Amen.
I mean, it's a law, brother.
Amen.
It's a law. The
Murayo.
No, 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 no. Whatever differ, Murayo wa kindi u lock or ora. So that you get in. Or to lock, so that no one comes in or goes out. The faith that you have,
what can
put into action? You start by opening up your mouth, speak what you believe, and act on what you believe. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Right in the house, when you want peace, start speaking about it from
the beginning.
Then from there,
act
it.
But
you
are the
devil who is a thing. Is the spirit of it's the spirit of unforgiveness.
Ndimuya wasa kona hangwera.
Namuya uri ndinya go vasumbedza. Vasongo tenda kuva namuya wo vasumbedza. Kha vha tendo vha namuya wa what different.
Yeah.
Muya wa lutendo.
Amen.
Andi pakri pane zwa kuti ngo vhakatwa mure na mudzimu. Don't be ignorant in things. Chipo mo ribe ignorant ka zwithu. Chipo kamba fetori. Richi dilana zwithu. Ari be sober. Ri apply ya lutendo rune ra vana.
Amen.
For you to raise those kids.
Uri vana vatara rusara na vana.
It demands your faith to be applied.
Zvita da uri vana machimisa rutendo.
What you speak.
Zvine vamba.
What you believe.
Zvine vatenda.
In season and out of season.
Da chuma to dai samba.
What you speak.
Zvine vane vamba.
It is the one that will undo what the devil has done.
Zvine ra dakuru ra dzaisa kana
iyi. If you wait for a miracle from America.
Ba wana ndindela dembe libva America.
Ava ndiva ndiva ku devil. Vone vote go dzura pa pandaro. Vone madembe alani. Ane asatu wonwai acha vashumera ngori dembe linde vone baba na no ndu pangiwa munye wa ukona utenda.
Amen.
Nga huna munye wa ukona pangiwa ukona utenda va vona neri khou rita nga panga munye wa mudzimu uri kha u shume ndi dembe la kuli huru.
Amen.
Because when you touch
it must be
moved. It must be a
bow.
Some of the madam has any on officer. I tell about the Norimas to go with more cheer. Bakus, you wanna get Farama for Hana get a Rabat whoever to do. What God did? How much is the drama to go on? What about people to go? Whenever my teacher tapped with a Jenanga and a chitaba with so slow. So that they walk under the glory of God. You are supposed to walk under the glory of God because of the faith that God has given to you. You have the miracle in yourself. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
The miracle is in you.
Yeah.
Can we say, I have the miracle of God?
I have the miracle.
The face of God in me,
creates my miracle.
Hallelujah. Because it doesn't come from man. Go straight to the mountain. If God says, live by faith. I have evidence. And the evidence
is this way.
Nothing else.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Don't allow your joy to be stolen. You have got the faith that maintains your joy.
Amen.
May we take this opportunity.
That is the
and I call these people to come back. As they are coming back, let me sum up this thing. You know, God is saying to us, my dear children, apply your faith. It's not the faith that comes from you. It's the faith that comes from me. Apply it. Don't remain with the knowledge that you have. Because the faith that you have must be able to calm down whatever the devil is trying to say. We just give glory to the Lord for the faith God has just upon us.
Rena, 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 R lutendo lwe abapa nga lupfale lukolta tendo lupitia muzimuni nga uliniene afurau nila yavo akonyaga tendo yavo akonyaga matali akonyaga mano ukonyaga tendo zichezakayo muya wanga
muya wanga
Oh,
kumudine no fuli walichitia wabone wone bofara lutendo la doba successful ulirebelo mbanga direbeliwa mara aunga bina success ngauri greater is he that is in you than he that is in His name is Everlasting One.
Amen.
We serve the God who is mightier.
Amen.
We serve the God who never fails.
Amen.
We serve the God who is above everything.
Amen.
And we are in Him. We live in Him.
Amen.
When we apply our faith, it comes to pass.
Amen.
By faith, you are a conqueror.
Amen.
By faith, God is near you.